Hi, I'm Elaine Maria Stea and I'm working for Igalia. I'm going to talk to you about the OpenGL interoperability extensions and our work to support them on different method drivers. The aim of the interoperability extensions is to enable the user to allocate the resources that are required for rendering like textures or buffers from Vulkan once and reuse them several times from both APIs, from both OpenGL and Vulkan, and synchronize the access of those APIs to these shared resources. An example of an application that would use interoperability is a VR compositor where the left and right eye images would be allocated and displayed by Vulkan, but their contents would be filled by OpenGL processes. Now, the OpenGL interoperability extensions are grouped in two main categories. The first one that contains the X-memory object FD and X-semaphore FD enables OpenGL applications to import memory objects or semaphores from POSIX file descriptor external handles. And the second one, the X-external objects category, contains the extensions that enable OpenGL applications to create OpenGL objects corresponding to Vulkan ones and synchronize access to shared objects across APIs. It also extends some existing GL calls at set and query properties with new properties. Igalia contributed to the implementation of the interoperability extensions for different method drivers, but also to piglit, because there were no conformance tests available for these extensions, and so we've written a Vulkan framework for piglit and some tests that cover the most common X-external objects and X-external objects FD use cases. More specifically, we've implemented the extensions for the Iris driver and our branch is under review. We've also implemented the feature for FreeTreno, and that work is upstream. And we are currently working on fixes to the radio NSI implementation that were for problems that were revealed after running the piglit test, because the extensions were already implemented for the AMD driver. And also we helped with the review of the I-965 implementation of these extensions that was implemented mainly by Iroan Garg here from Collabora. And I'd like to thank all the people who contributed to this work with patches or reviews or comments and advices. I have all the names here because they are too many. And I'd like to particularly thank Tapanipali from Intel, who helped us a lot with his patches and his comments and his reviews on the work for Iris. Now on piglit, we've covered some possible use cases of these extensions. The first group of tests is about reusing color images, and the most simple use case is the VK image override, where Vulkan allocates images of different formats and tiling modes, then fills them with green, and we expect to see a green screen for each image. Then next test is VK image display, where Vulkan creates an image and fills it with colored bars, this pattern here, and then OpenGL draws the image on screen using semaphores to synchronize access, and the expected output is this striped pattern on screen. Then next test is VK image display override that also creates an image and fills it with Vulkan, and the pattern that is created from Vulkan is this one. Then OpenGL overrides that image with another stripes pattern, this one, and then Vulkan reads back the contents of the image. We expect to read back the modified contents of the image. Then next group of tests is about depth and stencil buffer exchange. And in the first test, which is the VK depth display, we draw a quad at a specific test to fill the Z buffer with a recognizable pattern from Vulkan. Then we use that Vulkan Z buffer from OpenGL, where we clear the frame buffer to green, and then we render a blue full screen quad positioned on the z-axis further away than the depth of the original quad. And then if the z-buffer has been imported correctly, the quad is partially obscured due to the depth test failing in the middle, as you can see here, where the all pixels are blue, but in the middle we see the green frame buffer color. Now the VK stencil display is quite similar. The Vulkan creates a pattern in the stencil buffer, and then OpenGL draws a blue full screen quad with the stencil test enabled, and we expect to see the quad masked by the stencil pattern, like here, where the pixels that pass the stencil test are blue, but the rest of the pixels are green, which is again the frame buffer color, the screen frame buffer color. Now, next group of tests is about reusing pixel buffers. In the first test, VK buffer exchange, Vulkan creates and fills an image with color bars and copies each content to a buffer. Then OpenGL uses this Vulkan buffer as pixel storage for a texture and displays it, and we expect to see the striped color bars on screen. Then next test, VK pix buff update errors, is quite similar to the previous one, but then OpenGL attempts to override the buffer, and we expect an invalid operation error to be generated and the buffer to remain unchanged. Now, the following tests and the final ones are about reusing vertex buffers. The first one, in VK vertex buff update errors, Vulkan creates a vertex buffer and fills it with only the odd quads of the HS board pattern, so that not all quads we see contain geometry. And then OpenGL clears the screen to red and draws the vertex buffer in blue. Also, it attempts to override the vertex buffer object. What we expect to see is a red-blue chessboard pattern on screen and an invalid operation error due to the attempt to override the buffer. Now, the VK vertex buff reuse is very similar to the previous one, but instead of attempting to override the buffer, we reuse it from Vulkan in a render pass that also draws the same chessboard, and we expect to see the chessboard on screen. Many people helped us with the work on the tests and the framework as well. Juan Suarez Romero made some contributions and also helped with the first test cases and did a lot of testing. And then Tapani Pali, who did all the reviews. and a lot of testing as well, and he sent us some patches for the framework. Then it's Bas Nieuwwijzen who sent us a framework patch to support dedicated memory which is required for the radio NSI driver, and we didn't support it. Then, and finally it's Toby Pohjolainen who had made a first attempt to write tests for this extension some years ago. The tests weren't upstream, but they gave us an idea on how to start, and we had them like a reference for the very, very first tests we've written. I hope I'm not forgetting anyone here. Thanks to everyone who made contributions. And let's see our conclusions from running the tests. First of all, most of the piglit tests are passing in the MESA drivers mentioned before, which is very good. It means that the implementation is probably correct. But unfortunately, MESA does not support yet the depth and stencil buffer exchange. The only implementation I've found that currently supports this feature is the NVIDIA proprietary driver. No MESA driver supports it yet. Also, we found some issues with the radio NSI, but most of them were caused by our changes to the state tracker, and we are working on the rest. I hope that I have the chance to answer questions during the XDC, but in case we just play this recorded presentation, you can email me at this email or ping me on IRC where my nick is Hikiko. Here are some links that might be interesting. The first one is a category in my blog where I'm planning to continue posting about the piglit use cases I've explained before. And these two links are the specifications of the extensions I was talking about. And that was it. Thank you very much for watching and have a nice day or evening. Bye.
Okay, we are now live for questions. So, Eleni, you're live. Okay, so.
Hi.
There is a question that is, are there plans to support this on Nuvo?
Actually, I haven't checked Nuvo yet. I don't know if it is already implemented or it completely lacks support for the extension. Mm-hmm. So for the moment, there are no plans to support it, but maybe in the future.
Well, Jason Extrand was saying we need a Nuvo Vulkan driver first, which is a fair question, a fair statement.
Okay.
Another question is, what MESA version is targeted for the Iris free dreno work?
I think that for the free dreno it is upstream, so I suppose the next MESA version will have it. For the Iris, I don't know. I'm not sure if it will be in the next release or later, because the branch is still under review.
Okay. I think this is the last question, but maybe we can give another 10 seconds or so, the last one. I mean, we are way ahead of time. Okay, then I guess that was the last question. Thank you very much, Eleni.
Thank you very much for watching.